My question is for you, Teresa. You lauded your success as a two-term mayor of a predominantly African-American city. I've spent a lot of time in Columbus and Muskogee County. I was just down in Macon, Bibb County yesterday, administering COVID-19 tests. And I can tell you that I hear from a lot of constituents in Columbus their disappointment of your leadership and your failures to create robust economic opportunity for African-Americans in the city that you led, and your failures to create Black cultural districts. Can you speak to your failures in not creating such districts in a predominant African-American community?
Oh my goodness, I would always love to please 100% of the people and get 100% of the vote, but 68% and 63% are pretty good. And as I said, carrying those African-American precincts with over 80% of the vote, I think, does speak to an affirmation of the type of leadership. And I'm not sure who you were speaking with, but we actually, one of the marks of my leadership was reversing blight by lifting up predominantly minority communities. We did several things off of Victory Drive, which is an area that's been struggling for some period of time, passing tax allocation districts, and also in a place called City Village, which was very culturally and community stressed because of blight. But we started to turn those things around by building up the communities and not having 15. Gentrification, which is really amazing. And so, again, I think that, you know, my reputation speaks for me. We were able to reduce the unemployment rate by more than half and provide tremendous opportunities and increase the wealth of of our folks here. So I'm not sure where you got your information, but thank you for the opportunity.
Ms. Dillard Smith, do you have a rebuttal?
I do. Thank you so much. Well, certainly Liberty Theater has been a hot button issue and it's being widely debated right now. I'm in constant contact with individuals who serve on the board. And there's a deep sentiment of a failure to, you know, robustly invest in African-American economic opportunity and real estate. I can tell you certainly as we are combating this COVID crisis, affordable housing and development and equal opportunity in those resources as we pass infrastructure will certainly be critical. And we need a leader in the U.S. Senate that certainly understands economic opportunity.
Thank you very much.
Well, we did, in fact, do that. Liberty District has been controversial. You're right. And it continues to be today. But you didn't mention Arbor Point or Chase Homes or Patriot Point or any of the other wonderful homes that we did in partnership with our housing authority to really elevate communities here, Columbus Commons and so many others are national examples. So, again, thank you for allowing me to clear that up.